starts to move out of here? Or...
definitely came over here. Town Suffolk definitely got hit.
For assault.
There you go.
Being treated for a brain tumor and has a compromised immune system. She was on a very rare outing, she said, and she was wearing a mask.
Jackpot.
So. Yeah.
Isn't that fantastic?
Yeah. In other news, as our own theme park, Busch Gardens, is preparing for the beginning of its phased reopenings this week. They put the tickets up last week for this, like, beer fest thing that they were having.
Yeah, roller coasters, it's brews and coasters or something like that.
Yeah, so passengers at another theme park had a bit of an issue. People who were riding Disney World's Mountain Log Flume tweeted about a scary experience where their boat took on water at the end of the ride.
Really?
They wrote, "So we got out of our boat because it was sinking while we were stuck there." They wrote, along with a video of the waterlogged vessel. The video is pretty creepy because you can see how deep the water is.
All right.
They're not, like, really describing it. You can hear the worker who's, you know, trying to tell him to stay on the vessel.
Stay in the log?
Mm-hmm. The Disney World employee decided to tell us that we should have stayed in the boat, but it went under as we stepped out.
Oof.
... Nice.
Bad idea.
Another passenger on the ride tweeted a pair of before and after photos. The first one showing her and her boyfriend seated in the ride with water up past their ankles. The second of the mostly submerged boat. Five people ultimately left with injury, according to a Disney spokesperson.
Wow.
Now, I get why they were telling him to stay on the ride, because back in the year 2000,
yes,
a 37-year-old guy got off of the flume mid-ride, just halfway through, and he ended up being hit by another boat and
Hell
was
yes.
killed.
Oh, yeah, that wouldn't surprise me at all.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm sure that you have to stay with the vehicle, if you will. That water's not that deep.
No.
There's no point to it.
By the way, last month, Disney did announce that Splash Mountain would be rethemed as the Princess and the Frog, what they're going for. So, the incident was reviewed. Splash Mountain has since reopened. One visitor who described the scene also said Disney World was eerily quiet amid pandemic measures.
She said, I saw it go and I reached for it and I missed it. And then I saw it hit the water and then it went on fire. She's like, that's, you know, it's cooked.
Yeah.
It's done.
Yikes.
But it was a kind of an epic ending. That is pretty cool. You know, you watch it hit the water and then the water lights up.
I'm still going with EF.
Centers or feminist
really?
Organizations and asked to speak to the man in charge. So I'll tell you how that's going.
The man in charge.
Coming up at the 8 o'clock news.
Yeah, the man in charge.
I know, but right now, let me give you a weather update. Tropical storm conditions expected at least for the next couple of hours. Rain, possibly a thunderstorm, showers possible as we go through lunchtime. Wind is what we're dealing with right now. As you can probably tell, there's a lot of wind. So some of the storms could produce heavy rainfall. I mean, it did this morning. A high in the mid-80s today. Partly cloudy tonight, 77 is your low, and a slight chance of showers tomorrow. Mostly sunny otherwise. Highs again in the mid-80s. Right now, we are at 78 degrees, and I am Shelley for Rumble in the Morning on FM 99.
Look at where we are. 366-9999. Let me grab this over here. Hey, line one. Hi, good morning.
Good morning. Nothing to do with the storm, but back to the theme park mishap.
Uh-huh.
My dad, when he was a teenager, was on a roller coaster. The seatbelt came undone.
Oh, baby!
To this day, he won't even get on Tilt the World.
Terrifying.
Yeah.
Terrifying. When I was a kid, I did something similar happened to me where the thing didn't latch all the way, and I was hanging onto that bar. Oh man. Fortunately, back that long ago, they were pretty straightforward roller coasters. Big hill, up a hill, down a hill.
Let me tell you something, honey. I bet my old ass can whip your young and arrogant ass any day of the week. Problem with people like you, Wendy, is that you think everyone owes you something. Modern day teachers do nothing but complain, and then they take 3 months off in the summertime. Those are the facts, so deal with it. Hashtag, guys don't care about your feelings.
It's Facebook Bites, bout number two.
Everyone, be aware that at 12:23 a.m., someone broke into my husband's truck. If anybody was able to catch anything on your cameras, please let us know. I'm just glad my man didn't catch those punks.
There's a group of people hitting our neighborhood. What did they get?
A gun, a little loose change, and a special CD carrier that my husband really treasured.
Why are you all leaving your guns in your vehicle? Idiots!
motherfucker.